Hello students, I welcome you all. Presently we are dealing with Girish Karnad's historical play Tughlaq. So far we completed 9 scenes out of 13, and in this class I am going to talk on scene number 10. Now all of you have a very comprehensive idea of the development of the plot since we started with the very first scene there in Delhi. Gradually we proceed with shifting of the capital to Daulatabad. We had a few scenes over there on the way to Daulatabad, and now we are in Daulatabad Fort. As the curtain rises for scene number 10, Muhammad is looking out of the window of his palace, that is Daulatabad Fort. His stepmother comes in his chamber and she shows some concern about the affairs of the state. She talked about the killings, starvation, death, robbery, and all such sorts of incidents which were taking place time and again in the jurisdiction of the state. Being the mother of the Sultan, she expresses her concern and requests Tughlaq to take certain steps in this respect so that the situation will be under control. One more important topic she initiated from her end is that of the counterfeit currency. She tells Muhammad that she has heard that there are 500 cards of counterfeit coins. As soon as this dialogue is uttered by the stepmother, Muhammad bin Tughlaq expresses his frustration and confusion. First of all, he was in the denial mode, but later realized that there is no point in rejecting the fact. Then he accepts his mistakes and says that if he doesn't withdraw the coins now, the entire economy of the state will be in the shambles. But he cannot do anything in this respect, for it was his own orders. as a matter of fact, that was not the legal currency. Hence, there was no doubt that it was a kind of illegal robbery. But he could not help at all, even though these things were done as per the orders of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Officially, he could not send the counterfeit coins to his treasury. And as the result of it, they will be heaped in the rose garden. Now I would like to read out a long dialogue uttered by Muhammad bin Tughlaq in this respect. Tughlaq says, "Now, I don't need a rose garden. I built it because I wanted to make myself an image of Sa'di's poems. I wanted every rose in it to be a poem. I wanted every thorn in it to prick and quicken the senses. But I don't need those airy trappings now. A funeral has no need for a separate symbol." So this dialogue, which is uttered by Muhammad bin Tughlaq, indicates his inclination to be an idealist. But in the course of time, he failed even as an idealist and the Sultan of the state. He has not been able to stop the unending line of the Caucasus because several killings and several deaths due to different reasons. He is now trying to find out who is the murderer of Nazim. I hope you still remember that Nazim, then and then Wazir, was the most confident person of Sultan Muhammad bin Tughlaq. And he wanted to know the fact that who was behind the curtain who played a major role and killed Nazim. He adds on one more information right in front of his stepmother. He says that he has got a hint from the servant to Halaluddin, who had committed suicide. According to Tughlaq, Halaluddin committed suicide because a servant overheard him telling his wife about the murderer. So he must be someone very important in the hierarchy of the state. And just to save someone behind the curtain, he might have killed himself. The stepmother immediately realizes the importance of the situation, and she knows the fanatic ways of Tughlaq's administration. She expresses her wish that everything should be all right in the state, but her addition in this particular interaction, that she is really happy that Nazib is no more now, raised the eyebrows of the Sultan. According to the stepmother, Nazib was misleading and always kept Muhammad bin Tughlaq astray. As soon as Sultan heard this kind of statement pronounced by the stepmother, he got annoyed and wanted to know the murderer. Then you see, the biggest ever disclosure of the fact over here is that the stepmother revealed the fact that she herself is behind this conspiracy of killing Nazib. Since he was the chief advisor, means since Nazib was the chief advisor of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and actually Nazib was really responsible to bring down the image of the Sultan as an idealist, and in order to save the kingdom, in order to save the image of the Sultan, she killed Nazib. The moment Muhammad bin Tughlaq came to know the fact that his own stepmother is the conspirator and behind the murder of Nazib, he really lost his temper. He suddenly realizes that his own stepmother killed Nazib, who was the most confident person of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. And see now the reaction from Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He coldly stares at his mother and tells her that whatever task you have done, whatever conspiracy you have done, that itself justifies that the conspirator should be punished. And punishment for this treachery is nothing but death. The others died unjustly, but according to Muhammad bin Tughlaq, she deserves death. Tughlaq says that she is worse than an adulteress. And immediately he passes an order to his soldiers to take her away to the prison and stone her till death. As soon as the stepmother listens to the order issued by Muhammad bin Tughlaq, she requested him not to stone her till death. But ultimately, she is dragged away by the soldiers, and it was decided that she should be stoned till death. But she kept on crying and begging the Sultan for not really killing her and continue to stone her till death. So this is the consequence of this misdeed that the lady did in her life by killing Nazib. Once the stepmother is taken away by the soldier to the prison, and as per the orders she was given the punishment, मोहम्मद फेल्ट लोनली एंड आइसोलेटेड. द सिचुएशन एंड द सर्कमस्टेंसेस इन द स्टेट कंटिन्यू टू टॉर्चर हिम मेंटली एंड ही रियलाइज दैट ऑल हिज एफर्ट्स हैव गॉन वेस्ट एंड नाउ ही स्टार्टेड फीलिंग हिमसेल्फ हेल्पलेस. नाउ यू सी द फर्दर स्टेट, द मेंटल स्टेट ऑफ द सुल्तान दैट रिवील्स सो मेनी थिंग हियर. मोहम्मद फॉल्स ऑन हिज नीज एंड क्लचेस हिज हैंड्स टू हिज ब्रेस्ट. नाउ यू सी व्हाट एक्चुअली ही इज गोइंग टू डू. ही सीक्स गॉड अलमाइटीज हेल्प एंड इम्प्लोर्स हिम टू कवर हिम विथ हिज इनफाइनाइट मर्सी. सी नाउ, तुगलक हैज रियलाइज्ड द फ्यूटिलिटी ऑफ लाइफ. तुगलक हैज रियलाइज्ड दैट ही लॉस्ट ऑल बैटल्स. ही इज नाइदर ए सक्सेसफुल ह्यूमन बींग, ए गुड जेनरस ह्यूमन बींग एंड नॉर ए सक्सेसफुल सुल्तान. एंड देन ही प्रेज इन वन ऑफ हिज डायलॉग्स हियर. I would like to quote the dialogue, very important dialogue of the play. Tughlaq says, while praying, God, God in heaven, please help me. Please don't let me go off my hand. My skin drops with blood and I don't know how much of it is mine and how much of others. I started in your path. Lord, why am I wandering naked in this desert now? I started in search of you. Why am I become a pig rolling in this gray mud? Raise me, clean me, cover me with your infinite mercy. I can only clutch at the hem of your cloak with my bloody fingers and plead. I can only beg. You have pity on me. I have no one but you now. Only you. Only you. 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 So this expression by Tughlaq indicates that he himself has come to the conclusion that he is a complete failure. No more further justification is required. But the sense of pride, the power and authority in hand, the kind of mentality that this man has actually stops him to coming down to the ground reality. But at least he has realized that whatever misdeeds, mischiefs, wrong things, manipulations, murders and so on that he did in the course of his lifetime, they proved to be meaningless now. Here, this scene comes to an end with the entry of Burney. Burney enters in the chamber of the Sultan and informs the Sultan that Ghiyasuddin Abbasid is going to arrive at Daulatabad in the span of the next month or so. As soon as the Sultan came to know this message, Of course, he was elated because he also wants to have some peace of mind, and that is all possible only with holy men like Abbasid. The Sultan is repentant and tells Birni that he has condemned his mother to death because she was responsible for the murder of Nazib. But in fact, he is not damn sure about it, as he came to a conclusion that she is responsible, and that's why he has already punished her and she is going to be stoned till death. He tried to pray but could not do so because Tughlaq is totally disturbed now mentally. He felt that he was on the brink of madness. See, this realization is also very important. Earlier also we came to know that the people started calling him mad Tughlaq. Now he himself is going to realize that he is mad, he is insane, he is lunatic. And that lunacy can be seen in his behavior. And this is how this scene number 10 comes to an end. So in my next class, I will deal with scene number 11. So thank you very much for the day.